beautiful day, so we decided to head down the coast south of Adelaide to a place called Blanche Point with Gull Rock for a more ambitious flight. So we made it. At first everything went really well. We had an onshore breeze, so I took off into the breeze to get the feel for it for control. Flew along the coast, beautiful looking down, no problems. So fairly light breeze, I'd say 15 to 17 kilometres an hour. So turned into the wind, and then with wind behind me came back along the coast. Noticed picking up speed, but not too bad. What I did notice too was pushing me inland a little bit, but got over the point and I could see Gull Rock, Blanche Point, beautiful view. So I turned out to sea into the wind, and again I'm looking down on the patterns in the sea and I'm wrapped. What I'm seeing even through the goggles is fantastic, so I know through the high-res camera hanging below the Bug 3 I'm going to be getting some good footage. Again, it's blowing me slightly inland, so I came over the tip of the rock there rather than off the coast a bit, but that's okay. So flying over where we've launched from the sand, and I thought I'd do the classic along the wave break flight. And at this point I'm feeling very comfortable with how everything's going. So this time I turn the other way, and again it pushes me inland, but that's alright. I'm up against the line of the cliff, and I think, hey, that's a great bit of footage. So fly along the cliff face and think, fantastic. And get up to here, you can see Gull Rock, and I make a huge mistake. At this point, I turn inland. And as I turn inland, the wind is pushing me down a bit, and I lose visual contact, and I'm gone. So dropping out of the sky at the top of the cliff, I've got a long scramble up a path to get to the cliff, and then a long look to find the thing. So I took my goggles with me, and wandered around until I eventually got a signal, and gee, I was thrilled when it finally came back. And what I find with the Aomway goggles that I didn't know about, if I'm only getting reception on one antenna, it'll say L or R, so that helped me to locate it. It's a pity I forgot to turn my V-Fly beacon on, because that would have beeped it and taken me straight through it. But hey, you don't do everything when you get up to fly. I'm just glad I got the drone back and can get back for another flight.